Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. Can we all stand as we worship our God today? Before we worship, I want to read from 1 Corinthians 15, verses 56 and 57. It says there, the sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. Verse 57, and this is the reason why we get to worship God. This is the reason why we could lift up our hands freely and worship His name. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, maraming salamat that we get to worship you alone, Father. Maraming salamat for the people who are here ready to worship you, to give thanks to you, and also to hear from your word, Lord. We are expectant, God. Even for the people who are watching, Lord, may you speak to them, God. May we worship you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Come on, let's worship Him.
Morning, church. Come on. Let's clap our hands and worship our God this morning.
Thank you.
It's normal. normal po malungkot. And may mga times nalulungkot ako at night. And what I do, I try to remember happy moments. Or I try to think of happy moments in the future. For me to be excited, for me para makatulog at maging komportable ako. I try to remember and think of happy moments. And this morning, I realize what we're going to do. We're gonna remember what Christ did for all of us. And this is not just to give us happy moments, but this is actually, this, what we're doing, it gives us hope. What He did for all of us, yung ginawa niya po para sa ating lahat, is the reason why we can worship Him because of what He did on that cross. He died on that cross, He risen, He resurrected to save us from all of our sins. Not just for happy moments, for us to have happy moments, but to have hope. To have hope that He is our Redeemer. To have hope that He is our healer. When we feel sad, when we feel down, for some of us, you're going through a lot of things right now. Church, this is our hope. And when we remember this, I hope that we would be filled by His love. Because the reason why He did this, because of His love for all of us. Today, again, we will remember what Christ has done for us. And communion is one way of celebrating it. It is a remembrance that Jesus has forgiven us, offered Himself to us, for us to redeem us from our sins. If you're not comfortable doing this with us, it's okay. But we invite you to pray with us as we do this. Allow me to read from 1 Corinthians 11, verses 23 to 24. It says here, "For I received from the Lord what I also pass on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" Not for anyone. It's for all of us. You don't have to do anything. You don't have, you just have to accept it. "This is my body, which is for you." That's the reason why Christ died on that cross. Verse 25, it says here, "In the same way, after supper, He took the cup, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes." Church, that is the reason why we are doing this. For us to have hope. For us to be hopeful in our lives. Broken for us, that we could live, Father, freely, Lord. Lord, maraming salamat, because for some of us, we feel broken right now. For some of us, we feel crushed from the things that we've been experiencing from this world. But God, we pray that right now, as we do this, as we remember what You did on that cross, we would be whole again. That we would be hopeful, that we would have that hope. Thank You, God. Thank You, Christ, for dying on that cross. And right now, we just want to be grateful. We just want to be grateful and say thank You to You that we could do this together, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. Church, the body of Christ broken for us, and all we could say is thanks be to God. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for your blood. Thank you for your blood that shed for all of us. And our sins, Lord, alam namin, hindi namin kaya linisin yung sarili namin sa lahat ng mga kasalanan na ginagawa namin. Pero Panginoon, maraming salamat kasi ngayong araw maaalala namin kung anong ginawa mo sa krus para sa amin, na tinanggal mo lahat ng kasalanan namin sa buhay namin. Thank you for cleansing us by your blood, not by anything or any works that we can do, but only because of your blood, Jesus, we are cleansed. In Jesus' name, amen. Church, the blood of Christ shed for you, and let's all say, are you grateful that we get to do this? I'm grateful that we get to do this as a spiritual family. We're gonna continue to worship God, but before that, let's just pray. Lord, thank you for the hope that you've been giving to us, Father. Salamat, Panginoon, because we feel refreshed, God. That's because of you, Lord. That's because of your presence here. And right now, we will worship you. We will worship you with our hearts, that our hearts are cleansed from our sins because of your blood. And right now, we will sing, Yeshua, our healer. Yeshua, our redeemer. The redeemer of our lives. The healer of our lives. That this mental health that we feel, that this sins that we're carrying, all gone. We feel broken, all gone. That's because of your power. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen.
Yeshua, Yeshua.
this is our prayer, that we will follow you, God. Lord, we want to see you. We want to see you through our situations, Father. Jesus, we want to follow you, not just today, but every single day, every single moment. Lord, no turning back. No turning back. Have all of us, Lord. Lord, we worship you. We glorify your name, and we are forever grateful for what you've done for all of us. We praise you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Come on, worship God. Give him praise. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome to Victory. And before you take your seat, why don't you tell the person next to you, Happy 40 years. Once again, good morning, everyone. I know you have your communion elements na trash dyan sa inyong mga upuan. Pwede nyo po yan iuwi para palagi nyo maalala yung... Hindi, pwede nyo po itapon yan as you go out. Please don't leave the trash on your seats. Again, happy 40th year, Victory Mandaluyong. 40 years of honoring God, 40 years of making disciples, because God is faithful for the past 40 years. And that's the reason why we are celebrating our 40th year this year. So if hindi pa po kayo nakapag-register sa ating celebrating victory or victory conference, please register sa labas, paglabas nyo, para magsama-sama tayo at mag-celebrate tayo ng 40 years of God's faithfulness. Now, saying, I mentioned a while ago, 40 years of honoring God and making disciples. That's the reason why we want to encourage you, if you're not yet part of a small group, please do approach us right after the service so that we could walk with you and we could journey with you. And yun po ang reason bakit nandito pa rin tayo for 40 years, because of spiritual family. Also, because of Jesus, period, but also because of spiritual family who journeys with us. So we encourage you to please do approach us right after the service so that we could connect you to a small group. Now for our tithes and offering, let me call Honey Lou.
Hello. Thank you, Kevin. Good morning, everyone. I am Honey Lou, one of the small group leaders in Victory Mandaluyong. For our tithes and offering, let us read from Matthew chapter 6, verses 33-34. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. So while studying this verse, these verses, there are two phrases that stood out. One, seeking the kingdom of God. It means we will put God first, our priority, and our relationship to Him over anything of this world. Second is the, therefore, do not be anxious. Himayin lang natin ng konti. Anxious, it is in Tagalog, nababahala, nababalisa, nag-aalala. Nag-aalala na tayo sa mga bagay na hindi pa naman natin alam kung ano yung mangyayari. And therefore, is the word used to convey a conclusion or an end result. So therefore, do not be anxious is a command from Jesus that we should not be anxious about anything, because God knew already what we need even before we ask Him. So today, the battle is to trust God always happening in the current state, not tomorrow, not on the next year, but today we should always trust God that He will provide whatever we need. And worry distracts us from seeking the kingdom of God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, God, for today. Thank you, Lord, for giving us another opportunity, God, to worship you through our tithes and offering. Lord, may this be a pleasing aroma to you. Lord, we ask for your forgiveness, God, for the times that we are trusting ourselves and not trusting you, Lord. But God, thank you because you are faithful. No matter what happens, thank you, Lord, because you are faithful. Lord, we lift up everything to you. Bless every tither in this room. May you honor their faith, God. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. We have envelopes on your chairs. We encourage you to write down your prayer requests or answered prayers. We would love to celebrate and pray with you. You may drop them at the back right after the service. Thank you for continually giving to the kingdom and his kingdom work. Enjoy the rest of the service.
God praise today. Ayan. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Pero mamatingin yung katabi mo, good morning sa'yo. Yeah. So, sabi mo naman sa kabila mong katabi, I'm glad that you're with me today. Yeah. So, lalo kung asawa mo yan, medyo gawin mong sweet ng onte. Yeah. So, I'm glad you're here with me today. Yeah. So, and really, it's every time we got to have the chance to gather together, talagang I see it as an expression of God's grace. Diba? Imagine parang we're from different backgrounds, we came from different places, we came from different situations, and yet, on a weekend, something like this, talagang may chance tayo to gather and hear the Word of God, and hear ano yung direction niya for us in our lives and even in our church. May tumutunog ba? May nangyayari ba? Yun, hello? Check. Okay naman. Okay. Sige. Right. So, we are continuing our series, Jesus Period. Pero bago po pala yun, ako po pala si Stephen. I'm one of your campus missionaries here. And I'm so grateful for Pastor Dennis for giving me this privilege and honor to be able to preach the Word of God in front of everyone today. So, we pray that as we look into the Word of God, we will find hope. Yung sasabi ni Kevin kanina, we will find hope. And we will continue to pursue the life of faith that God has given for each and every one of us. Amen? And now we're continuing our series, Jesus Period. And this is more than just this.
Sige, mukhang kailangan ko nang gamitin to. Alright. So we are, again, itong series natin na Jesus Period, this is more than just a series title. This is part of our core values as a church. Hindi lang, magandang title yun, Jesus Period. No, this is our way of really communicating to the whole church that this is one of our core values. In fact, meron po tayong limang core values as a church. And I think we'll get into that some later on. But today, ito, we'll be focusing on, for me, this is the most important core value, which is about Jesus Christ. Kaya Jesus Period. Hindi po aksidente na ano yan, ha, na may period. So talagang may period yan because there's a point. Bakit may period? Gets niyo point, period. So, sige. But basically what we're talking about here is what we're talking about is the Lordship of Jesus Christ. This is one of our core values, the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Because we see Jesus Christ as Lord, plain and simple. Okay, he's not just any other man. He's not just any other prophet. He is not just any other religious figure. But we see Jesus Christ as the Lord. Not just of our lives, but over everything. Amen? And that's why sobrang importante mo itong series natin. And we're looking actually into the book of Colossians. And amazingly, the book of Colossians, 4 chapters lang ito, pero it talks about in detail ano yung character ni Jesus Christ and how it affects our lives and how we should live our lives in the context of His Lordship. And yung Lordship, talagang ano to eh, it's the only title that was given to the one who only deserves it, which is Jesus. Wala na tayong ibang tatawaging Lord, wala na tayong ibang tatawaging Master, kundi si Jesus Christ lang. Amen? And that's why we can see, last week, Pastor Dennis preached about Colossians chapter 1. It talks about who Jesus is. It's more than just Him dying on the cross. And yes, that's the peak of His plan, to die on the cross to save humankind. But because He died on the cross, what does it tell us? It's about His character. It's about who He is, even in the beginning. And that's why makikita po natin in Colossians chapter 1, verses 18 to 20. It says here, talks about Jesus, and He is the head of the body, the church, the people of God. Tayo po. There's no other head in this church kundi si Jesus Christ. No one else except Him. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything He might be preeminent. When you say preeminent, it means being superior, being above everything, being in authority over everything. He was in the beginning. That's why if He is in the beginning, then that means He is preeminent. Kumbaga, nauna na siya sa atin. He knows everything. Even when the whole universe was empty and void, the Lord was already there. Jesus was already there. He is preeminent. For in Him, all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell. And through Him to reconcile to Himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of His cross. This is who our God is. And every time we come here, every time we live our lives, this is a reminder, sino ba yung Diyos na sinaserve natin? He is first, He is the head, He is preeminent, He reconciles everything to Himself, but ultimately, in His desire to reconcile everyone, He died for all of us. Can you imagine that? He is the head, and yet, He served everyone, even with His own life. That's the kind of God we serve. And that's why yung salvation natin is completely hinged on the Lordship of Jesus. Do you believe that you're saved? Do you believe that when you die today, you know that you will go to heaven? Because you know that you have Christ in your life. Ngayon, ano bang basis nun? Ano bang kasiguraduhan natin? The assurance of that is the Lordship of Christ. And which makes sense. Kasi paano tayo ililigtas ni Lord kung hindi, paano tayo ililigtas si Jesus kung hindi siya Lord, right? Because if He is Lord, then He has all the power. Then if He has all the power, then He has the power to save us from the very thing that we cannot save ourselves from. Tama po ba? I mean, naalala ko po nung grade 1 ako. Yan, grade 1. So, nag-outing kami sa bandang Laguna yon. Tapos, magsiswimming kami. Tapos yung nanay ko, dinamitan na ako na, ano, na pang-swimming. Siyempre, bilang bata, excited na mag-swimming. So, sabi lang nanay ko, oh, ano, antayin mo lang ako ha, huwag ka munang tatalon sa pool kasi malalim, pang-adult na pool yon. So, ako excited na bata. So, paglabas ko nung, ano, nung kwarto, nakita ko na yung swimming pool. Tapos, eto, kunwari, ito yung swimming pool, no? So, pumunta ako dito sa edge. Tapos tinignan ko, parang, uy, parang mababaw lang. Kasi di ba yung reflection, kala mo ang babaw lang. Tapos all of a sudden, umatras ako. So syempre, excited. Tapos tumakbo ako, pabunta dito, then tumalon ako sa gitna ng pool. Tapos dun ako nalunod. So as in sobrang ano, parang sobrang vivid sa akin noon. I consider that as, uy grabe Lord, thank you, may second life ako. Kasi kung walang... Kasi mayroong matandang nag-swimming din doon eh. So wala nakakapansin sa akin na nalulunod daw kasi nasa ilalim na talaga ako. Tapos sabi nung matanda sa akin, hindi masabi ng matanda sa akin, sa isip daw nung matanda, nakikita niya ako, lumalangoy. Parang tagal niya sumisid. So, tapos nung na-realize niya na nalulunod na ako, doon niya ako inahon. Without that person, I cannot save myself from being drowned. Someone has to pull me up, who has the power to pull me up. In the same way, we were drowning in our sins. We cannot save ourselves. It only takes an external power, authority, to be able to remove us from the very thing na hindi natin kayang iligtas ng sarili natin. And that's the picture of the gospel. That's the picture of what Christ did for us. Again, that's why yung salvation natin, we cannot just say na, Lord, you are my Savior, but I don't recognize you as my Lord. Hindi pwede yun. Because our salvation is completely hinged on the Lordship of Jesus. And as we're looking into the letter of Colossians, sinulat ni Paul to the people in Colossae, although yung church na yun is very faithful, nag-grow sila, nireport yun ni Ephra Fes ata pangalan, basta letter E nagsisimula. Nireports kay Paul, kasi si Paul never siya nagkaroon ng personal encounter with that church. And Paul did not plant that church personally, but it was Epaphras who planted that church and giving report to Paul na talagang nagiging faithful sila. However, may mga nakakapasok na mga false teachings about, kumbaga, denying the very identity of Jesus. So, Paul had to write this kasi may threat nang nangyayari, so kailangan na niyang maagapan na hindi totoo yung mga tinuturo ng mga iba. Okay, na kailangan ka pa kumapit sa angels, si Jesus is just one of the gods. So, kailangan ma-cancel yun agad. And one is that there are false teachings nga about Jesus and his finished work. Kumbaga, ang sinasabi ng mga false teachers, Jesus is not enough. Jesus is not enough, which is in contradiction sa tinuro ni Epaphras. Okay? Sa tinuro ni Epaphras, which is yung gospel ni Jesus. And Paul had to remind them. Kumbaga, si Jesus is just an addition to the other gods that they already have. Ngayon, in our time today, actually hindi lang naman sa time natin ngayon, ito yung mga gods, some of the gods that are being portrayed throughout the whole world. Diba? And kung makikita nyo, si Jesus is just one of that. Right? And ito yung sitwasyon nung Colossae. Ito yung sitwasyon nila na marami kaming gods, maraming gods ang prevalent sa culture namin, and may mga nagtuturo sa amin na hindi lang si Jesus yung kailangan namin, but there should be other gods. In fact, even mga angels, kailangan mag-call out kami sa kanila. So, yun yung mga turo. And in our time today, hindi man natin kilala yung mga gods na yan, but we have our own versions of our gods. We're Christians, we follow Jesus, and yet unknowingly, again, the word unknowingly, pwedeng hindi tayo conscious, or maybe hindi pa natin alam talaga, meron pa rin tayong mga gods, quote-unquote gods, na sinusunod. Diba? So may mga lucky charms, may mga dinidisplay tayo sa businesses natin, sa mga bahay natin. That would, in a way, wala namang masama eh kung ilalagay ko. I love Jesus, pero wala namang masama kung ilalagay ko itong mga bagay na to. We're like what to whom Paul is writing to in Colossae. And naalala ko, meron kaming kinainan dito sa Mandaluyong. Hindi ko na sabihin kung ano. Basta may kinainan kami. Napagpasok ko, nakita ko ang daming mga decorations. Tapos may nakita ako doon sa gitna. I think the word is, Jesus be the center of my business. Parang ganun yung thought nung furniture na yon. And then I looked around. Oh, merong gumaganon na pusa. Oh, dito merong Buddha. Oh, dito merong ano. So, tas dito merong ano, parang about luck. Ganun. So, kumbaga parang halo-halo na. And yet, may kita mo sa gitna, Jesus be the center of my business. Okay, so, it's so confusing. Diba? Nakakatawa siya. But, that made me think, Lord, ganito rin ba ako? I may not have those furnitures and other things, pero, Lord, meron ba akong mga certain ideologies, meron ba akong certain mga beliefs na pinaniniwalaan ko na hindi aligned sa iyo? That's not in conformance to who you are and what your plan is. And may mga invisible tayong mga gods or philosophies na sinusunod din. Diba? Just like itong mga words na ito. Diba? Yung mga manifesting. We have this law of attraction. Christians tayo, pero when it comes to money and finances, mamanifest ko yan. Diba? The whole universe favors me. Diba? We can be Christians. We can be loving Jesus. Sincerely. And yet, pwedeng may mga nahalong mga other beliefs. Other philosophies na alam natin, if we really think about it, Lord, hindi pala to galing sa'yo. Diba? Mga swerte or malas. Diba? And then yung mga believe in yourself. It sounds so good. It sounds so encouraging. And yet, if we really consider Jesus as our Lord, then this is not part of what He is commanding us to do. Unknowingly, we confess Him, and yet we still hold on to these things aside from Him. So, hindi nagiging Jesus period. Kasi pag sinabi mong period, kumbaga, tuldok na yon, wala nang kasunod doon. He is the only one. And sometimes, hindi nagiging Jesus period yung nangyayari. Ang nangyayari is Jesus and this. Jesus and my money. Jesus and my business. Jesus and my career. Jesus and my title or position. Jesus and my reputation, my image sa mata ng mga tao. Jesus and my political bet. Jesus and my church. Diba? Oh, talaga ba? Yes. Sometimes, we consider the church, this, itong, as something that's in addition to na si Jesus lang talaga yung kailangan natin. Jesus and my pastor. Jesus and my minister. Jesus and my someone who prays for me always. The list can go on and on and on and on because there are limitless possibilities na si Jesus is hindi maging enough for us. And yet, what the Bible is telling us, specifically in Colossians, He is preeminent, He is before all things, He is in the beginning, and through His cross, we are being reconciled to Him. So that's why, Jesus, period. Jesus, period. Can we willingly and wholeheartedly accept this? Na God, yes, Jesus, period. I submit to your lordship. And that's why we're going to look into the second chapter ng Colossians today. Medyo intro lang po yun. Okay lang ba if we can stand as we read the Word of God today? Sabi mo sa katabi mo, alas 12 na pala. So, Colossians chapter 2. Verse 6 and 7. Therefore, as you received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him, rooted and built up in Him and established in the faith, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. Let's pray. God, as we look into these two verses, God, I pray that this will make clear to us what it means to be under your lordship. God, maybe for some of us, ang concept ng lordship has been, should I say, traumatic, Lord, na parang it has been about just do's and don'ts. Pero Lord, I pray that as we look into this, we will have a greater and deeper understanding of what it means of receiving you as Lord. Thank you. May you bless the preaching of your word in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's all take our seats. Again, yung verse po na tinignan natin is dependent on what was preached last week. So kung wala po kayo dito last week, we encourage you, meron po tayong Facebook page. go to our page. Meron po doon mga, yung mga live recordings natin. Go to the preachings of nung last week so that we have a greater glance of ano pinag-usapan from last week. And basically, itong Colossians, it talks about who Christ is. And because ito si Jesus, yung chapter 1, yung last week na pinag-usapan natin, anong ibig sabihin nun sa atin? Lahat ng pinag-usapan natin in the last 15 minutes, what does that mean to us now? What does that mean? Anong ibig sabihin sa atin nun na when we see Jesus as Lord over our lives? And siguro, yung chapters 2 to 4, chapter 1, it talks about the foundation, the who Christ is. But chapters 2 to 4 talks about the Paul giving practical insights in light of the foundational truth that was being shared in chapter 1. And trivia lang po, for emphasis, kung titingnan niyo po yung Colossians, Jesus was purely referred as Lord, not as Savior. Thank you for technology. Talagang nag-control F lang ako sa laptop ko. Tapos tignan ko yung mga per chapter. Tapos tinype ko yung word na Savior. In Colossians, walang lumabas na Savior being referred to Jesus. But when it comes to Lord, every chapter, He is being referred as Lord. So ganun sobrang in-emphasize ng letter na to, yung identity ni Jesus as Lord. So let's look at verse 6. Therefore, as you receive Christ, Jesus, the Lord, so walk in Him. When we look into that word receive, receive means receiving with the mind. So ibig sabihin nun, yung itong act daw na to of receiving Christ is a conscious, willing, and free decision. As you receive, hindi siya yung parang, hindi ko alam, di-receive ko ba siya? Ata. So, hindi. It was a conscious, it was a free and willing decision. It's as if your whole life depends on it. So that's why kailangan major decision to. Kumbaga, in marriage, kailangan buo yung decision. Alam mo na ikakasal ka sa kanya, di ba? So, hindi yung parang nagising ka na lang, asawa na kita? So, hindi ganun. Receiving Christ is a conscious, free, and willing decision. So, sinasabi, therefore, as you willingly, as you consciously, as you freely receive Him, you made Jesus the Lord of your life, so walk in Him. The Bible commands us to not just receive Christ, but as we receive Him, we ought to walk in Him. Kasi ang receiving part, kung titingnan natin, it's an one instance thing, di ba? So naalala niyo pa yung time na yon na you made that decision. Maybe some of you students pa kayo noon. Maybe some of you mga young adults. Or maybe some of you na-invite kayo ng anak nyo dito sa church, tapos doon nyo na-realize na, ganito pala si Jesus, so you made that decision in following Him. And iba-iba yung story natin doon. So recall that moment. When was that time that you made that decision? And that time, isang beses lang nangyari yun. Or maybe some of you, kahit every service, you made that decision, di ba? So, may mga ganun, di ba? And that's okay, di ba? That's okay. That's your decision. And remember those moments. Pero when we say we ought to walk in Him, we see na hindi lang siya one time. It's something that we continually live on. And when you say walk, ang ibig sabihin ng walk dito is to live a life conformed to the union entered into with Christ. So, walk. So, walk in Him. Ang picture nito is, when you say walk in Him, syempre sabay kayo. Diba? Pag example, may inaya ka, uy, tara, punta tayong Pure Gold. Pure Gold. So, Pure Gold. Diba? So, punta tayo Pure Gold, punta tayo sa PG Food Park. Alam niyo kung ano yung PG Food Park? Pure Good Food Park. So, punta tayo doon, bili tayo ng ano ng siomay. So, sabay kayo, 'di ba? hindi mo sinabihin na, "Uy, tara, lakad tayo," tapos mauuna ka. Or mauuna siya. Hindi, when you say walk in him, you are together in walking. Kung nag-aya ka maglakad kasama ka, syempre sasamahan mo. Parehas kayo ng pacing, parehas kayo ng direction. So, it means walking in God means to live a life in union, conforming, life conformed to the union entered into with Christ. So, tayo yung sumasabay kay Lord. Tayo yung sumusunod sa direction ni Lord. Tayo yung sumusunod sa pacing ni Lord. So, walk in Him. You see, we cannot, when you say conform, it means to abide, to follow, to align, or to act according to. So, yun yung sinasabing conform. And when we say we walk in Him, the problem is we cannot receive Christ into our lives and still, tayo pa rin yung masusunod sa buhay natin. Hindi pwedeng mangyari yung ganun. That we receive Him, tapos tayo pa rin yung magdidesisyon sa buhay natin. Tayo pa rin yung masusunod. Lord, pag Sunday, I enjoy this time of worship. Pero Lord, pagpasok ko sa office, kasama ko na ang aking kachismisan. Oo nga, no? Grabe siya, no? No. As we receive Christ, we walk in Him. And when you say walk, hindi sinabing step, right? Kasi ang walk, it's a continuous step. Walk is already progressive in its nature. So, hindi sinabi, so take a step in Him. No, we walk in Him. It's continuous, it's a journey of walking with God. And very important yung word na in Him. Okay? In Him. Very important to understand. Since we receive Christ, we are already in Him. The moment you made that decision, you are in Christ. Tell that person sitting next to you, you are in Christ. Okay? Meaning you belong to Him. You don't belong to anybody else anymore. You belong to Jesus Christ. And I can't help but think na when we are in Him, that means we are under His rule. We are under His care. We are under His sovereignty. We are under His provision. We are under His command. We are under His miracles. So when we say that Jesus is our Lord, hindi lang ito yung Lord, sige susunod ako. Yes, yun yung essence noon. But at the same time, it also means, God, thank you because I am under your care. You are watching over me. You are my Lord. Kumbaga, Lord, I'm under your radar. You see me. You know the ins and outs of my life. That's what it means when we say, God, you are my Lord. And I can't help to think, si Enoch. Kaya nyo ba si Enoch? Very short na description sa kanya. In Genesis chapter 5, sabi nito, Enoch walked with God. After he fathered Methuselah 300 years and had other sons and daughters, thus all the days of Enoch were 365 years. Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. Amazingly, kung titignan mo natin yung part na yan, wow, 365 years, ang tagal. Pero kung titignan nyo po yung before and after Enoch, relatively, maikli lang yung buhay ni Enoch. To others, that's 900 plus years, 700 plus years. But for Enoch, 365 years only, and yet, he was commended as someone who walked with God. So it's not just about how long we live our lives. It's about how we live our lives, how we walk this life that we have. So with the short life that we have, here on earth, we are called to walk in Jesus. Amen. And then, anong itsura nung, as we walk in Jesus, how will our lives look like when we walk in Jesus? And we see that in verse 7. Sabi dito, therefore, as you receive Christ, Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him. Ito yung itsura ng buhay natin when we walk in God. Rooted. Pero po sabihin sa katabi mo, rooted. Sa kabilang katabi mo, yung inuugat. Sabi mo, inuugat. Yan. Tapos tignan mo yung paa niya. Hindi, joke lang. Rooted. Being rooted means being grounded. Being firm, being stable, being settled. And it's a picture na ginamit ni Paul in agriculture. Kaya ang picture talaga niyan is yung puno. And alam natin na kapag nagtanim, hindi naman agad ano yan eh, pataas. Palalim muna ang growth niyan. So roots is very important. Kapag imagine, kapag hindi rooted or grounded, just like tree, what will happen? Kapag walang ugat ang puno, ano mangyayari sa puno? Mamamatay? And then ano pang pwede mangyayari sa kanya bago siya mamatay? Matutumba? Because kapag may mga winds, kapag may mga external forces nangyayari, and then mabilis matumba ang puno. That's why the roots are important, because kahit anong mangyari dito sa external, as long as you're rooted, then you will be immovable. You will be unshakable. And it's a picture that Paul gave to his letter, being rooted. And I remember in Psalm, anong itsura ng being rooted na yon? Psalm chapter 1, verses 1 to 3. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. And on his law, he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in its season. And its leaf does not wither. In all that he does, he prospers. That's what it looks like when we say that we are rooted in Christ. That we don't join the world, but we're in it, but we don't join in the systems of the world. Pero we delight in the law of the Lord. We delight in God. That's what being rooted means. Yun yung itsura natin when we walk in God. He will cause us to be rooted. And then the next part, sabi dito, not just rooted, but built up. Okay? Palalim, and then paangat. Being built up. And itong term naman na ginamit ni Paul, it's referencing to architectural context. It's like building a house. And being built up in Him. And we see in 1 Peter, sabi dito, you yourselves, like living stones, are being built up as a spiritual house. To be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. We are being built up as a spiritual house. And that's why meron tayong ganitong church community. This is not just a gathering on a weekly basis, but this is the spiritual house of God. We are being built up into Him. We are being built up as a spiritual house. So meaning, as we walk in Jesus, He would cause us to be built up. Na hindi lang tayo the same way, that we were not just born this way. Di ba? Hindi lang yon. But God has made us so that He can build us up, mature us, develop us, Christ-like character. Kaya sabi doon, being built up as a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood. We are being built up in our identity in Jesus Christ. We are being built up in our spiritual worship to Him. na mas nagkakaroon tayo ng deeper understanding ano ba talaga ang worship, na hindi lang siya about songs, hindi lang siya about a moment on a Sunday, but spiritual worship is how we live our lives to God. We are being built up in our purpose. And that's why it's inevitable as we receive Christ, it's inevitable na we will walk this journey alone. Hindi may iwasan yun na tayo lang mag-isa ang naglalakad dito sa journey na to. God will intentionally place us in a community, in a family wherein we can be built up. And I pray that as we're here today, as we consider this church as our spiritual family, I pray na ang prayer natin is, Lord, would you use me? Would you use these people to build me up? But at the same time, God, use me to build someone else up as well. And that's why, in this church, meron tayong solo moms na community. Okay? And I want to speak to the solo moms na nandito, or maybe solo dads. You're not alone. Christ is with you. And Jesus had established this church for you. So please, don't fight this fight alone. Jesus wants to build you up together with others. So we encourage you. Meron tayong community dito. We encourage you. Please. Please. Join us. Another thing. Meron tayong couples community. Okay? Meron tayong mga families na merong community. Na hindi, ang community is hindi lang within the biological family, but having a deep understanding na, Lord, yes, we are a family, pero God, alam ko na meron kaming mga other families that we can connect to so that we can help each other in being built up as we follow Christ. So meron tayong mga couples dito. If you're married, we encourage you. We have this kind of community here. Don't do marriage alone. But we have a spiritual family for you. And meron tayong season generation. Yan. So, season ang tawag natin. So, yan. Parang hindi naman, ano. Okay. So, sige, di ko na sugarcoat. Mga senior citizens. Okay, so. Saludo po ako sa mga seniors dito sa church natin. Very selfless, very mothering, very fathering ang approach. Sobrang saludo. Na even in their late age, and this is to honor you, okay, not to ano. Even in your late age, you still serve the Lord. And that made us, the younger, look forward into that moment na kahit, Lord, senior na ako, I'll still serve you. And that's the example of that. So again, don't walk alone. We have a community for you. And of course, meron tayong mga young adults na community. Diba, yung picture na iba lang na ano, sila nasa jogging sila. So, hindi, pero we have the young adults. Kung fresh grad ka, if you are a young adult working, meron din tayong community for you. Matindi ang laban sa labas. Tama? Matindi ang laban sa office. Matindi ang temptation. So, mahirap mag-thrive in our Christian walk kapag tayo lang mag-isa. We need people. We have young adults. And of course, together, in our 40th year, meron tayong Victory Conference. This is not just a concert na gagawin sa MOA. Hindi, that's not it. This is a moment for us as God's people to gather, being built up as a spiritual house. So this is a moment for us to see the bigger picture kung anong ginagawa ni Lord na hindi lang sa Mandaluyong, Pero we can see what God is doing in the whole nation. Even throughout the whole world, we will see what God is doing. All of this, lahat ng sinasabi, itong shinare ko, all of this is because we are being able to walk in Jesus. Bottom line, kaya tayo mga ganito mga klaseng communities, because we're able to walk in Jesus. Kasi kung wala si Jesus, walang ganito mga communities. Magiging social clubs lang to. But because Jesus is the head, then alam natin bakit may mga gandong communities. He builds us up. So, here's my encouragement after sharing all of this. Walk in Jesus. Under any circumstances, in every season ng buhay mo. Anong circumstances natin ngayon? Nahirapan ka ba sa buhay ngayon? Then I encourage you all the more. You need help. Or are you okay with your life? That's good. We want to celebrate with you. Praise God. In any under circumstances, walk in Jesus. In every season of your life, walk in Jesus. Hindi tayo gagraduate sa paglalakad kasama si Jesus. Walang graduation dito. Siguro ang graduation na lang natin is eternity na. Yun na yun. So, pero as long as we're living here on earth, there's no stopping in walking with God. So any season, under any circumstances, walk with Jesus alongside with others, with the church. Bakit tayo binibuild up? Here's the purpose. That you may proclaim the excellencies of Him who called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. So that as a church, with Jesus being our Lord, we can proclaim who He is to the world. Then in verse 7, balik tayo. Being rooted, being built up, and being established in the faith. As we walk in Jesus, we will be established in the faith. Itong word naman na to, ang ginamit ni Paul dito is, it concerns either legal or educational terms. Yung being established. Meaning, yung we know, we exactly know, ano yung meron tayo. Ngayon, our walk with Jesus, since sabi dito, being established in the faith, our walk with Jesus is actually based on truth. Hindi ito wishful thinking lang. Oo, feeling ko may Jesus eh, somewhere there. Alam ko may God, somewhere there. Hindi. Realistic and tangible yung reasoning natin. Bakit tayo merong faith? Our faith is not blind. It is based on real, factual, truthful evidence of who Jesus is and what He has done for us. So, hindi blind faith yung ginagawa natin. But it's based on the person of Jesus Christ. Our faith is based on the established written Word of God. That's why every week in the service, hindi nawawala ang preaching of the Word. Hindi nawawala ang exhortation about the Word of God. In our small groups, hindi nawawala ng pag-usapan yung Word ni God. Because our faith is based on the established written Word of God. Kung saan, mas makikilala natin who Jesus is. And ito yung danger if hindi tayo established in the faith. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 14. So that we may no longer be children, tossed to and fro by the waves and carried out by every wind of doctrine. The danger is, if hindi tayo established, patapon-tapon lang tayo. Makaka-benefit ba sa akin yan? Sige, puta ako dyan. Ipasok ko yan. Tapos nalimutan na natin si Jesus. Sabi dito, so that we may no longer be children, being tossed to and fro by the waves, by human cunning, by craftiness, in deceitful schemes. Scam ka na ba? Yung ganun yun eh, deceitful schemes. Promising sa umpisa. Pero pag nandun ka na, na-scam ako. Ganun daw yung false teachings. Ganun daw yung mga human cunnings, craftiness, kung hindi tayo established sa faith. Rather, speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in every way into Him who is the head, into Christ. That's why we also take time to establish the church in the Word of God. Just this month, ongoing po ito, we're taking time to establish students in the Word and in the faith. We're conducting our Purple Book class itong buong month ng April. Okay? And nasa second week na kahapon, and sobrang amazing how these students are really hungry learning about who God is. And that's what I realized. Grabe, Lord, mga kabataan ngayon, oo, Lord, ito yung mga nakikita namin, di namin maitindihan, pero deep inside of them, they're eager to learn who God is. They're eager to learn ano yung purpose nila sa buhay, who they are in God. And we take this time because we want to establish every believer into God's Word and into faith. And as we get involved in this, as we are being established in the faith, at the same time, one way to being established in the faith is to actually do it. Exercise yung faith natin. That we don't, na ang Christian life natin, hopefully, is not just, okay, I'll hear, I'll sit, then goodbye. But I pray that there is an external, there is an action involved. How we can advance the kingdom of God all the more. And this is just my way of saying, meron tayong opportunity, church, to be able to preach the gospel to the students. Literally, opportunity, kasi dito gagawin, merong magkakaroon ng recollection. Ang MPNAG, grade 12 students, graduating, and the principal asked us mismo, tayong church, to conduct this, not in their school, but here. And that's 800 students being able to hear God and receive the gospel. Now, what's our part here? We need volunteers. We need people who will serve with us. Kasi kung kaming pitong campus missionaries lang, hindi namin kayang kausapin ng 800 students. And the question is, Lord, saan ba kami hahanap ng pwedeng mag-serve kasama kami? Sabi ni Lord, huwag ka nang lumayo, nasa church na yung mga tatawagin ko. So it's one Friday, that's next week. If you can free your, if you know God is calling you to be part of this, then He will give you all the necessary means para mapunta ka dito. If it means filing a leave, if it means doing an offset, I don't know, hindi ko alam. But kayo na ni Lord yon kung paano. But if you are not just interested, but if you are answering the call of God to be part of this, then we have a registration available. You can take a picture of that. Pag uwi nyo, pwede kayo mag-register so that we can contact you ano yung pwede natin gawin, paano yung takbo nito. Basically, ang gagawin lang natin sa recollection, yung mga mag-serve with us, kailangan lang natin ng facilitators. Kasi may mga group discussions, kailangan may tatao dun sa group discussion na yon to listen to them. Yun lang, makikinig lang tayo sa kanila and then few comments. Pero makikinig lang talaga tayo sa mga estudyante. Can we do that? Serve with us. So as we walk in Jesus, we are being rooted, we are being built up, and we are being established in the faith. In all of these things, here's the conclusion. Sabi dito, just as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. From the beginning, as we receive Christ, as we walk in Him, as we experience all these things as we're walking in Him. Lahat ng yon, si Lord. Lahat ng yon, work ni God. Lahat ng yon, grace ni God. So our response, we abound in thanksgiving. Can we all stand? We're going to... I'm very conscious of the time. But we need to respond to this as a church. We need to respond in thanksgiving. And the immediate way that we can actually do that as gathered people is to actually sing songs, a song to God in worship. So can we just pray for a moment? Then we're going to take time to worship. Lord, as we look into your word, maraming salamat that all along, this is your work. That God, we are so grateful that we can have this chance, this privilege, coming undeserving people, we have the chance to walk in you. What a great love and what amazing grace that you have shown to each and every one of us. So Lord, as we're standing today, we want to profess, God, we want to walk in you. We want to continue this life of faith that you have given to us. So Lord, as we sing this, we declare that Jesus, you are all that we see. That God, there is no turning back to this amazing life, fulfilling life that you have given to each and every one of us. We worship you, Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Jesus, you're all I see. I know that you're with me. No turning back. No turning back. My cross I'll carry. Though no one goes with me. No turning back. No.
want to pray for one, some of you today. Just as you receive Christ the Lord, maybe you're here. You haven't made that decision yet. And we want to make this plain and simple, yet it's the Lord who invites you today. If that's you, you're making that conscious, willing, and free decision today. Would you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord starting today? If that's you, can we all close our eyes and bow our heads? If that's you, maybe this is your first time, or you've been coming here for quite some time, and you're saying, yes, I understand now. I want to receive Jesus Christ as my Lord. If that's you, would you raise your hand? And I'm going to pray for you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God, for these three people who have made that commitment, made that decision today to receive you, Jesus Christ, as their Lord and Savior. Sa mga nagtataas ang kamay, can you utter this prayer? Sabihin niyo lang ako in this prayer and take it to heart and talk to God as you follow me in this prayer. Lord Jesus, I recognize today that I am a sinner. I am nothing without you. I recognize today, God, and I confess that I'm drowning in my sin. So Jesus, would you save me from this pit of death? And I acknowledge today, Jesus, that I will receive your forgiveness today. And I want to make you my Lord, my Master, my King, my Savior. Starting today, as I receive, walk, I will walk in you. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord, for these people. In Jesus' name, can you put down your hands? Amen. Amen. For the rest of us, can we all lift up our hands as we leave? Lord, as we go out of this place, as we are being scattered, Lord, I pray that we will continue to walk in you. That wherever we go, God, we will follow you. Wherever we go, we will answer your call for us to show your love towards other people, God. And we will see miracles and signs and wonders will follow us as we proclaim and demonstrate your gospel. Maraming salamat, God. Jesus, you are our Lord. You are our Master. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you, everyone. Thank you for staying. See you next week as we continue our series.